Today, I'm going to go over changes that we would like to see in Outriders, and we're going to start right now. What's up, guys? Reckless here, and welcome back to another video. So today, we're going to talk about changes that the community feels should come to Outriders. And we definitely have a lot to talk about. And if you guys want to see more Outriders content in the form of class builds, legendary farming, official and fan-made lore, news, updates, and more, be sure to subscribe down below and turn on notifications so you never miss out on any video. So, before we get into what we would like to change, let me go over what we won't be covering in this video, and I will tell you why after. We won't be covering bugs in the game, inside or outside of multiplayer, game crashes, issues with the sign-in screen, missing gear, missing mods, sniper difficulty, or excessive knockbacks from creatures in Stargrave. The reason why we won't be addressing these is because the devs have already addressed this in their latest patch notes, and an update to these issues is currently being tested as we speak. If you want to check out the details of the latest patch notes, I will put a link to them in the description box below. So, I went to Discord, Facebook, Reddit, Twitter, and YouTube to see what it is that you guys think needs to change or would like to change inside of Outriders. Besides the mention above that we won't be talking about, we will be going over a few things that I feel could be implemented in a future patch. These changes and ideas are from all of the people that voice their opinions, and you guys know who you are. And if you are one of those people who actually did give your opinion or agree with any of the changes that will be listed, go ahead and shout out in the comment section below. Let me start this off by saying that a lot of these changes actually go hand in hand with each other as well. So let's get started. First off, I would like to say that I appreciate the devs integrating a mass delete option for allowing us to get rid of gear faster. But where the devs messed up in the process is that they gave us a mass delete option without a locking system, so we don't accidentally delete gear that we want to keep. We technically have a locking system in place. As of this video, Legendaries and the Hell's Rangers set have this system, although the Hell's Rangers set is a little bit better because they can't be deleted at all. Unfortunately, it's not transferable to other pieces of gear. I don't know about you, but I have accidentally deleted a few pieces of gear that not only needed, but also wanted for a future build. And me being me, I actually did this several times, including today. Especially the God Roll AR that's on screen, that is a tactical variant. It had crit damage, close and long range damage, with killing spree and bone shrapnel. I am still livid because it happened today, as I did mention, while I was making this script. And this is what Square Enix had to say after I made the ticket. Quote, "Greetings." And my name was obviously there. "Thank you for contacting Square Enix Support Center. We apologize for the trouble and inconvenience you have been experiencing with Outriders due to accidentally deleting a weapon. Unfortunately, we would be unable to assist you with your concern as deletions are permanent and the information would no longer be on our servers. We apologize again for the inconvenience, but if you have any other question or concern, please do not hesitate to contact us again, and we will be more than happy to assist you. Thank you, Anthony." Square Enix customer support. Let that sink in real quick. You have an issue, you make a ticket, they just come out and say they can't do anything. Now, I understand that Anthony may be correct. Or that could just be the response they give everybody who makes a ticket who deletes something by accident. But then again, how are we going to get all of our gear that was wiped from our characters that we are supposed to be getting God rolls in return if the information would no longer be on their servers? That just sounds kind of sketchy to me. But okay, I'll bite. If there was a locking system, then we wouldn't have to worry about accidentally deleting the gear. Then again, one could argue that we have a stash. And my rebuttal to that would be, it's not big enough. What some people need to understand is that the stash has 100 spots for gear. So if you have multiple characters, you have multiple pieces of gear that may be in the stash. The legendary gear alone requires more than 100 spots. There are 46 legendary weapons and 3 legendary sets per class, and there are 4 classes, which is 60 legendary pieces of armor, not including the legendary armor that is not part of a set. A lot of people like myself are going through the game, and we are going through it fast, and we definitely need more space in our stash for our gear. Personally, I think that the stash should have a total of at least 250 slots at a minimum in order to accommodate all 4 of the classes. Now, some people don't or won't make more than one character, but many of us have 2 or 3 characters. I have 1 character of each class. More stash room equals access to more inventory, and with both gear locking system and more access to inventory space comes presets. Having saved presets allows for so much more testing of our builds to figure out which tree benefits us or our team the most. This gives us a little bit more headroom to tinker around with our builds to either have the ultimate DPS or the perfect support role. And I like how all of this is flowing nicely together, and I promise I didn't write the script like this on purpose, but let's go ahead and talk about that DPS. I want to say that a good percentage of players that are running Challenge Tier 14 plus are top tree based. Not all, but the top tree is the DPS tree for all of the classes, and that is what the majority of the community are playing. If you are soloing Eye of the Storm, majority of the time, it's going to be top tree. And there is nothing wrong with that. Now, I am not saying nerf the top tree of all of the characters. I am saying that I would like it if the devs bring the other 2 trees up to par with the top tree. That way, it makes it so that the other trees are viable, so that the top tree isn't the only option for the endgame content. And I'm pretty sure a lot of people can agree with that. What I'm trying to say is that we need a good balance. I understand that some roles are support and don't do much DPS as the others. I get it. But a good anomaly build should be able to do as much DPS, if not more DPS, than an assault weapon based build with some sort of improved rounds. I mean, we are Outriders, and we were affected by the anomaly, which gives us our power. Just saying. Speaking of trees and classes, I feel that the Devastator needs a little more love. They are good in DPS. They are good with sustainability and health. But what about being good as a tank in general? A tank in most games do a lot that the Devastator doesn't do. For one huge example is Taunt. The Devastator doesn't have an actual taunt. They do have this pull ability, and I guess if you do it directly in front of yourself, it could be kind of like a taunt. Wait, no, it's not the same. The Devastator needs a taunt, a real taunt, an ability that can activate, and all of the ads start running after the Devastator when they taunt. I mean, you can even make the pull activate as a taunt for at least like 4 seconds when the pull releases all of the enemies. The Devastator needs a taunt. It really does, I'm sorry. But enough about the Devastator. Now, let's get into more feature-based changes that I feel should come to the game. Starting with something very, very simple, which is a map direction indicator. How many times have we looked at the map and seen our location, but we're confused in what direction we were looking at? We start running around just to realize that we are going in a totally opposite direction from the way that we wanted to go, then get into an unwanted encounter with either the beasts or people and get mad that now we have to clear our way out just to get back on track. There are no landmarks in the game that we can actually see with the map that could reference what direction we are actually looking at. So a map direction indicator would be a nice addition to the game. Next. In our ever so growing Discord, we have a section in there for game complaints, and it seems that there are toxic people in the Outriders community. Then again, this is in almost every community there is for gaming. These people end up kicking people in their team after beating bosses in an expedition so that the person getting kicked doesn't get the loot at the end. While it's not happening in my Discord, that is still pretty messed up in my opinion. Yes, you can report the person, but that really doesn't do much unless the devs start cracking down on it. So, the next thing I would say that needs to be added to the game is the removal of the ability to kick someone after a final boss completion and until all players collect their loot from the drop pods. Moving on though. Now, myself and some of my friends actually play Outriders on our PS5. And no, I am not bragging. I have friends that also play on their Xboxes, PCs, and PS4s. Communication is very hard with the other platforms except through the use of Discord. But the issue with this is you have people using different devices in order to use Discord while still having a headset on. And sometimes people only have one ear cup on so they can listen to everybody in the party and Discord at the same time. This issue can be fixed if we had an in-game chat system. However, I feel that this should have been implemented when the devs actually announced that we would be having crossplay in-game before the game was even released. But what can you do? Continuing on with this though, I have a high-end custom water-cooled PC that I built myself, aka Sky Daddy. But I play Outriders on my PlayStation 5. Since everything, according to Anthony's email, in Outriders is server-based, I would like to see cross-save become a thing in the future. That way, if I wanted to take advantage of all the power inside my PC, I would be able to do so, but play my same characters that are on my PlayStation 5 on my PC as well. I mean, who wants to buy the same game entirely over again and then restart everything? My PC is an amazing machine. It is extremely heavy, and you can't go lugging that around everywhere. My PlayStation 5? If I wanted to go to a family's home, I can bring that places, so it's easier to move around. So being able to play on both platforms with the same account is definitely a nice addition. Yes, the devs made it so we could play anywhere, but my account doesn't go everywhere, so cross-save would be a nice thing to see. So that is everything for part one of the changes that we would like to see in Outriders. Let me know down in the comments section if there are any changes that you would like to see in the game as well. And if you actually enjoyed this video, please leave a like. And that, my friends, brings us to the end of the video. If you need a place to play Outriders, come join the Everything Outriders Discord. Every platform is welcome. You can make new friends, get help with expeditions like Challenge Tier 14, 15, and Eye of the Storm, get detailed information such as data mines, patch notes, lore, and look at all the legendaries in the game as well. We are over 230 members now, and it's growing every single day, so come and join us. A link to the Discord will be in the description box below, and I will see you guys in the next one. Hey, you, watch these videos too. I know you like them. Go. Go.